Stand by ready? Good luck.
Welcome to the first issue of Games and Hardware. Today we are going to take a look on a very fine yet quite unknown pinball game for the Sega Saturn. It was only released in Japan. It is called the Necromonicum and includes three very nice designed and different looking tables. In this episode we're going to take a look on the first table, which is loading right now.
The book holds the names. The book holds the tales of the dreams and nightmares that forever will exist. In the shadows they live. Ancient tales they see, in stone they write, in the places hiding from you. Recover your soul.
As you can see, this game sports some very nice graphics, which is because this game uses the high resolution mode of the Sega Saturn, which was only used in a very few games. And well, the usage of this mode makes up for some very nice and sharp graphics on my LCD television, as you can see. As you can see, there are several very nice multiball modes in this game. There are multiple ways to get a multiball at each table. Getting a multiball is possibly the only way to get a high score in this game, because without the several multiball modes, where you can rack up some very nice scores in quite fast time, you won't be able to get into the high score list at all. Another reason to buy this game is the excellent soundtrack it includes. It was written by the progressive metal band Dream Theater and fits very well into the overall atmosphere of the game. Well, enough bubbling from me, enjoy a few more minutes of gameplay, and if you're interested in the game, well, watch out my YouTube channel. I'm going to take gameplay videos of the two other tables as well soon. See ya.
Silence.